So here we're going to talk a little bit about dangling modifiers. So these especially come up in the improving sentences. And what they are sentences that basically start with an introductory descriptive phrase. Okay? These can either be some of the easiest questions you deal with if you notice the strategy, or some of the hardest ones if you don't, okay? So I think the best way to learn dangling modifiers is through examples. So let's look at the first example I have here. So it says, having completed all his chores, it took Tom 5 minutes to change for the party. Okay? If you notice, I have an introductory descriptive phrase. So it says, having completed all his chores, comma. All right? Well, what you want to ask yourself is who in this sentence has completed all his chores, right? Because whatever shows up after the comma, right after, has to be the person, place, or thing that has completed all his chores. Well, in this sentence, obviously it's Tom who has completed all his chores. But right now, you have it that follows the comma. So that's the error, right? This sentence should actually move Tom to be after the comma. So you would rearrange the sentence to say something like, having completed all his chores, Tom took 5 minutes to change for the party. Okay? Because now this first introductory phrase is actually describing Tom, which it's intended to do, right? So that's dangling modifier, all right? You should look for sentences that start with a descriptive phrase and see if the word right after the comma is actually being described by that intro phrase. All right, so let's go to number two. Because of their great sense of smell, the sheriff department trains dogs to sniff out bomb threats. Okay, well, again, we have an intro phrase, because of their great sense of smell. Well, what in this sentence has a great sense of smell? Is it the sheriff department? No, not exactly, right? So the dogs in this sentence have the great sense of smell. So really, dogs should be the thing that comes right after this comma so that it's described by this intro phrase. So it should say something like, because of their great sense of smell, dogs are trained by the sheriff department to sniff out bomb threats. That's how you would rearrange the second sentence to be consistent with the dangling modifier, okay? So again, these are really, really simple if you see these intro phrases, right? If you see them, then you know that whatever follows has to be described by the introductory phrase.